Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan has blamed the RSS for making the Sabarimala temple a war zone. BJP has rubbished those allegations.
Chief Minister has accused the RSS of a conspiracy to block women from entering the Sabarimala despite the landmark Supreme Court order. As a proof, Chief Minister cited the planned attacks at even the houses of few women like Rehana Fatima and Mary Sweetie, who dared to attempt the trek up to the temple but met with severe resistance by protesters. But it's a three-way political slugfest. The Congress has hit out at both the state government and BJP RSS.
Persons has been tortured.
By whom? By whom?
By this BJP activist and Hanuman activist. Two parties, Hanuman activist and BJP activist. I saw, I was the eyewitnesses.
Do you recognize the people who were
yes,
doing
yes,
this?
Yes, I asked to somebody. And I know, I have confirmed it. Then only I tell that they are BJP, they are Hanuman people. Both LDF and BJP, they are playing politics.
The BJP, though, has rubbished the allegations.
Only the devotees are doing it. We are supporting them. As far as BJP is concerned, we are not directly leading any agitation there. The agenda set by CPM with a view to destroy the Sabarimala temple, and very cleverly they use this judgment as a weapon for defeating the believers.
However, reports submitted to Kerala High Court states that protests by frenzied devotees and protesters may lead to crowd turbulence and stampede in the festival season starting next month, leading to loss of life and injuries.
Even we are announcing it earlier itself, November 5th morning onwards, we'll be there having prayers in Sabarimala as a part of our resistance. November 13th, we are hoping for a Supreme Court positive verdict, and November 16th, we are again going to start it. And I would request Honorable Comrade Chief Minister not to take a confrontational stand. This government is not only of atheists, 99% are theists or believers. So please keep that in mind.
Sabarimala is set to open for its main season of 61 days starting 16th November, and the Supreme Court is set to hear the review petitions on 13th November. But all of this is boiling down to way beyond faith and practices. It's now a litmus test for the left government in Kerala. With camera person SP Babu, Sneha Koshi for NDTV.